Welcome to a lesson on how to factor by grouping. This video does assume you've already watched the video on how to factor out the greatest common factor. The factor by grouping technique can be useful when there is a binomial factor of a polynomial with four or more terms. Here is the idea. Let's consider the following polynomial with four terms, and let's just say we decide to divide this polynomial in half. And then take these two terms and factor out the greatest common factor of 2x squared. And that would leave us with x minus 5. And let's say we decide to do the same thing over on the right side. If we factor out the greatest common factor of 3, we'll notice that we have another binomial factor of x minus 5. So the idea behind factor by grouping is that we will always have a common binomial factor. So if we factor x minus 5 out of these two products, we are left with 2x squared plus 3, which would be our other factor of the original polynomial. Let's go ahead and formalize these rules. To factor by grouping, number one, we divide the polynomial into two groups, the first half and the second half. Step two, we factor the GCF out of the first half, and then factor the GCF out of the second half. Step three, we should notice a common binomial or trinomial factor, depending on how many terms we started with. And then step four, we factor out the common binomial or trinomial factor. So let's go ahead and give it a try. Step one, we divide the polynomial in half. Next, we look for the GCF of just the first two terms. We can see that it's going to be x. And we're left with m plus n. Now we do the same to the second two terms. The GCF of these two would be y. Since we will factor out a positive y, we need to write down plus y. If it was negative, we'd write down minus y. And this leaves us with m plus n. And again, we do see we have a common binomial factor of m plus n. Therefore, we can factor the m plus n out of those products, and we're left with x plus y. This is factoring by grouping. Let's do a few more. So step one, divide it in half. Step two, identify the GCF of the first two terms. In this case, it would be 3x squared. We'd be left with x plus 3. Now, these next two terms do not have any common factors other than 1 or negative 1. And since we want to have a binomial factor of x plus 3, we better factor out a positive 1. So if nothing's common, we can always factor out 1 or negative 1. And that would leave us with x plus 3. And again, we see the common binomial factor of x plus 3, which is what we can now factor out. So if we factor out the x plus 3, that would leave us with 3x squared plus 1. Let's try a couple more. Step 1, we divide it in half. Make sure we include the minus sign with the second half. The GCF of these first two terms would be x squared, leaving us with x minus 3. Now notice we want to have a factor of x plus 3 in the second product. If we factored out just 2, we'd have a negative x plus 3, which won't match this binomial. So sometimes we will have to factor out a negative. So if we factor out a negative 2, we would have a positive x, and then it would change the sign of the 6 to a negative 3 or minus 3. This matches the pattern we're looking for. We have a binomial factor of x minus 3, so we can factor the x minus 3 out, leaving us with x squared minus 2. Let's try number 4, cutting it in half. If you're having a difficult time finding the GCF, we could expand this as we did in the last video, but I'm assuming you can do that now. The GCF of these two terms would be 2x squared That would leave us with 6x plus 1. Next, the GCF of 30x and 5 would be 5. But since we want the binomial factor to have positive terms, let's factor out a negative 5. And we're left with 6x plus 1. Let's check that. Negative 30x minus 5, and it checks. And we also have that common binomial factor. So in factored form, we'd have 6x plus 1 times the quantity 2x squared minus 5. Let's go ahead and take a look at this problem, which states factor by grouping and then use the zero product property to solve the polynomial equation. So first off, notice this is an equation, not an expression. We know that because it has an equal sign in it. And even though we could combine these middle terms since they are like terms, let's not do that. Let's go ahead and factor it by grouping. So let's cut it in half. The GCF of the first two terms would be x, leaving us with x minus 2. The GCF of the second two terms would be 10, but since we need to have an x minus 2 factor, we need to factor out a negative 10 instead, leaving us with x minus 2 equals 0. And as before, we do have our common binomial factor of x minus 2. Let's factor that out. We'd be left with x minus 10 is equal to 0. Now, the zero product property essentially tells us that if we're multiplying two things together and we know that it equals 0, one of these has to be 0. So either A equals 0 or B equals 0. So applying it to this equation, this is like our A, and this is like our B. So either x minus 2 must equal 0, or x minus 10 must equal 0. Well, solving each of these for x, we would get x is equal to positive 2, and x equal to positive 10. These two x values would result in one of these two being 0, therefore their product would be 0. So we've kind of taken a step here from factoring to solving, but you can see this is one of the reasons why factoring can be important for solving equations. We will revisit this on the next several videos. Thank you for watching.